Hello friends, welcome to my channel, myself Parag Jambulkar. In last videos, we have seen different communication patterns. For example, one-to-all broadcast, all-to-one reduction, all-to-all broadcast, all-to-all reduction. And in last video, we have seen all reduce. All these are different communication patterns. In this video, we will see prefix sum operation. And also we will see how prefix sum operation is done over hyperqueue. But before that, we will see what do we mean by prefix sum operation, and then we will see how it is done on hyperqueue. So, name of operation is prefix sum. This is also called as cumulative sum. And this is also called as scan. Now, what do we mean by prefix sum or cumulative sum or scan operation? So that we'll see. Suppose we have some input array. For example, we have x0, x1. We'll take a capital one, so it will be better to understand. x0. x1, x2, likewise there are xn minus 1. So this many elements are there in input array. If we are applying prefix sum operation on this input array, then we are getting some output. And what is that output? Output is y0, y1, y2, up to yn minus. So here you can see what is prefix sum operation. Here is the input array is this x0, x1, x2, up to xn minus 1. So total there are n elements. What is the output? Output is this y0, y1, y2, up to yn minus 1. So again, just like input array, we got one series starting from y0 to yn minus 1. But what do you mean by y0? y0 is equal to x0. What do you mean by y1? y1 is x0 plus x1. What do you mean by y2? It is x0 plus x1 plus x2. In the same way, what do you mean by then yn minus 1? So it is x0 plus x1 plus x2 plus, in the same way, we will add it up to xn minus 1. So now it is very clear. What do we mean by prefix sum operation? We have input array, that is this x0, x1, x2, up to xn minus 1. So total we have n elements. From that, what output we are getting after applying prefix sum operation? This is the output. Again, that output consists of numbers starting from y0 up to yn minus 1. y0, y1, y2 up to yn minus 1. But what do you mean by y0? y0 is nothing but x0. What is y1? y1 is x0 plus x1. What do you mean by y2? y2 is x0 plus x1 plus x2. What do you mean by yn minus 1? It is the addition of all x0 plus x1 plus x2 up to xn minus 1. So here you can see y0 is equal to x0. Then we have added there x1, so we get y1. Again, in this addition, if we add x2, so we got y2. So in the same way, recursively or cumulatively, we are adding the elements. So see, here it was x0, we have added x1, so we got y1. Then we have added x2, so we got y2. In the same way, we will keep on adding, and at the end, when we are adding x minus 1, so we got yn minus 1. So whatever the result that you got, that is y0, y1, y2 up to yn minus 1, that is called the prefix sum, or it is also called as a cumulative sum. So this series we got from this input array. So y0 is equal to x0, y1 means x1 plus x0. What do you mean by y2? Y2 is x2 plus x1 plus x0. So one by one we are adding the elements, that we are getting cumulative sum, and that this cumulative sum, that y0, y1, y2 up to yn minus 1, is nothing but it is called as a prefix sum, and this is, it is also called as scan. Now we will see how prefix sum operation is done over hypercube. Hypercube is three-dimensional structure. It has x-axis, it has y-axis and z-axis. So nodes or processes are kept at nodes of hypercube. So this hypercube has 8 nodes, so there will be 8 processes. Now it is very simple. Here two things are there. One, it is mentioned in a round bracket, and another thing is mentioned in square bracket. So keep in mind, one thing is in a round bracket. So whatever the thing or whatever the number that is mentioned in a round bracket, that message or that number is sent to other node in next step. While whatever it is mentioned in square bracket, that message is kept with that process or node. Keep in mind that the simple rule we have to follow. Whatever there is in a round bracket like this, whatever it is there in a round bracket, so that number or that message is sent to other node in next step, while whatever it is there in a square bracket, so square bracket means this, so whatever message or number it is there in a square bracket, that message will, this message is kept with that particular node. One more rule is followed. So we'll have communication like this. Initially we have communication along the x-axis, then we have communication along the y-axis, and then we have communication along the z-axis. So communication will be done, and one more rule is get followed, that lower index process or node, lower index node will keep message in square bracket as it is. While process or node at the higher index will add message that it got from lower index node. That the rule we have to follow. So whenever there is a communication, so lower index node will keep the message in square bracket as it is, while the node at the higher index will add that message that it got from the lower index. So whatever the message it got from the lower index node, it will add in a square bracket. So that simple rule we have to follow. These are the notifications. Round bracket means that message is sent to other node in next step, while message in a square bracket is that message is kept with that node. Whenever communication will be done, so communication is will be done along the x-axis, then y-axis, then z-axis, whenever there is a communication, so messages from the round brackets will be shared. Messages from the round brackets will be shared among the nodes. And after sharing the messages from the round bracket, lower index node will keep whatever the message it has in a square bracket, it will keep as it is. While the node at the higher index will add that message into the square bracket. It will add that message into the square bracket. That simple rule we have to follow. Now look at this. So first communication is done over the x-axis. So look at this. 0 has 0, 1 has 1. So that 0 that is mentioned in a round bracket, that will be sent to 1. And 1 has 1, so that will be sent to 0. And that message, whatever there in the round bracket, that message is that particular process now. So look at this. 0 is transferred to 1, 1 is sending 1 to 0. So that another rule that we are following, 0 is a lower index compared to 1. So 0 will keep 0 in square bracket as it is. While 1 got 0 from the 0, so it will add 0 in this square bracket. So here you can see 0 plus 1, but here it is only 0. While in round bracket, 1 it got from 1, so that is 0 plus 1. 1 got 0, so in round bracket it has mentioned 0 plus 1. In the same thing in between 2 and 3, so 2 has sent 2 to 3, 3 has sent 3 to 2. But 2 is a lower index. 2 is a lower index compared to 3. So 2 has kept 2 in a square bracket, while 3 has added 2 in this square bracket. Here you can see 2 plus 3, but here 2 is 2 only. Okay, the same thing will be 6 and 7, and same thing will be 4 and 5. So here communication was along the x-axis. Now communication will be along the y-axis. So 0 have 0 plus 1, so whatever it is there in a round bracket, that will be sent to 2. 2 have in round bracket 2 plus 3, so that will be sent to 0. So here in same way there will be communication between 1 and 3. So 3 has in round bracket 2 plus 3, so 2 plus 3 will be sent to 1. 1 has in round bracket 0 plus 1, so 0 plus 1 will get sent to 3. Now see, when there is a communication between 0 and 2, so 0 is a lower index compared to 2. So what it will be done, 0 will not change the value in square bracket, as 0 is a lower index compared to 2. It will not add anything in the square bracket as it is a lower index. While 2 is a higher index compared to 0, whatever the message it get from the 0, so it will add in a square bracket. So already it had 2 and 0 plus 1 it got from 0, so it has added in a square bracket. Same thing will be done in between this 1 and 3. Same thing will be done along the 4 and 6 and 5 and 7. So same thing, same numbers or same messages you can see here. Next communication is along the z-axis. Z-axis means this is a z-axis, this is a z-axis, this is z-axis, this is a z-axis. Same thing, same rule will be get followed. Whatever there in a round bracket, that is get transferred to the another side. While there is a whatever there in a square bracket, that is actual message that the particular process will have. Now see, 0 and 4. So what 0 will send? It will send in whatever the message in a round bracket. So 0 have 0 plus 1 plus 2 plus 3. So that it will send to 4. What 4 have? 4 have 4 plus 5 in round bracket. So 4 will send 4 plus 5 to 0. So as 0 is a lower index compared to 4, 0 will not add in a square bracket. While 4, as it is a higher index compared to 0, whatever it got, it will add in a square bracket. So what it got from this 0, 0 plus 1 plus 2 plus 3, 0 plus 1 plus 2 plus 3, so it will add there. 4 it already had. In the same way, there will be communication between 2 and 6, 3 and 7, 1 and 5. Likewise. So at the end, what we got, 0 have 0, 1 have 0 plus 1, 2 have 0 plus 1 plus 2, 3 have 0 plus 1 plus 2 plus 3, 6 have 0 plus 1 plus 2 plus 3 up to 6, and 7 have 0 plus 1 plus 2 plus up to 7, and that is the cumulative sum. 0, 0, 1, 0 plus 1, 2, 0 plus 1 plus 2. That is called as a cumulative sum. That is nothing but the prefix sum. And we got the prefix sum at particular node. So here we have calculated prefix sum. But how it is calculated? By using a hypercube. And we have followed this simple rule. And at the end, we got this result. So friends, I hope you like this video. If yes, then click on like, subscribe to the channel, and don't forget to press the bell icon so that you will get notification of my next video. So stay connected. Thank you.